In this video, I will show you how I did this simple cinematic color grade using nothing but the CapCut app. Now there's two methods, two ways to arrive at the same conclusion. First, let me show you the way that doesn't involve any kind of presets or LUTs. Because I like to have the most control over my edits, I like to experiment a lot, I usually like to start my edits from scratch. So let's break it down, open CapCut and go to adjustments. Because this clip was shot on the phone, it was a little bit underexposed. Therefore, the first step is to go to brightness and just bring up the brightness to the normal level. Nothing special here. Now obviously that was the easiest part. You're probably wondering, how do we actually get those cinematic color grades? And my preferred way to achieve this on CapCut is by using the curves function. There's other ways to edit colors, including HSL and temperature, but curves are the most suited, especially for phone footage when you don't have that much data in the source file, when you haven't used a professional cinema camera to capture raw footage or something like that. But the great thing about curves is you don't need amazing high quality files. You can simply add or subtract color from the midtones, the shadows, or the highlights. And let me show you how to do this in practice. For this clip, the color grade is incredibly simple, to be honest. First, I went to the blue color channel and I've brought up the blue in the middle slightly to introduce kind of a blue contrast into the image. Now, if you're new to using curves, the middle part of the image is the midtones, the higher part of the image is the highlights, and the lower part of the image are the shadows. And you have three color channels, the red, the green, and the blue, as well as the regular highlights and shadows just in general. Now by bringing up the blue, we've introduced color into the selected part of the image, as well as the middle, which is the highlights. But for my liking, now this clip is a little bit too purplish, too blue, or either way, I want it to be a little bit more green. Now in order to make it green, I like to go to the red channel instead, and now I'm subtracting the red channel from the midtones. What happens when you subtract red from a purplish image? You get a little bit more of a green image. And when you combine that with blue, we get this cyan main color tone in the midtones of the image, which is the kind of color that I like for this particular scene. Finally, I've slightly tweaked the highlight and shadow curve by pulling down the shadows in order to add a little bit of contrast. Now this we could have done in the shadows section as well. It doesn't really matter which way you achieve the same result. Either one works just fine. Now, in order to fine-tune the image, we could go to HSL and individually edit some of the colors as well. To be honest, for this video, I didn't even do it because I liked the source file so much that a simple edit was fine, but I do often use the HSL function. Here's an example of what I could have done. The yellow color in this image, or in this video, is the main contrast color, so naturally, I would have selected the yellow and then possibly tweaked the hue. The hue changes the color hue or temperature of that individual color without affecting any of the other colors. So in this way, we could have gone to the hue and slid it to the left slightly, making it more orange. We could have gone to the saturation and increased the saturation even more to make it pop even more. But careful here, don't do it too much because oversaturated images just look kind of weird. And it's easy to go a little bit too far in that direction. And then furthermore, we're gonna go into the luminance, which increases or decreases the highlight bloom of that particular color. In this case, I would have probably increased it slightly. Now the other color, the main color in this image, is obviously blue, so I gotta go into the blue and again change the hue to my liking, probably a little bit more to the teals side. And I probably wouldn't too much, maybe increase the saturation slightly. Now actually, I'm curious to hear in the comments, what do you think about which one of these is better? Because originally I didn't do any HSL for this particular clip, but maybe it's better. Let me know what you think. And at this point, I think it's worth repeating a point that I like to say quite often. The most important part in recording cinematic footage is actually recording the cinematic footage. Color grading is an important part, but it's not everything, it's only a small part. Really, the source file is what's gonna make or break the success of your cinematic footage. Now, like I mentioned, the other way, the even simpler way to achieve a similar result is simply by using LUTs in order to achieve a cinematic color grade. Now, currently, the only way to use LUTs on CapCut is by using the desktop version of CapCut. If you're confused, I only found out about this recently as well. Apparently, CapCut has a totally free desktop version for both Windows and Mac. where you can actually use LUTs. So then the only thing you need to do is import your LUT and then change the intensity of the LUT. And if you pick the right kind of a video and paired it with the right type of a LUT, all you gotta do is adjust the intensity and maybe make a one or two different adjustments. You have less control if you never really learned how to totally edit things from scratch. So that's why I don't really only recommend doing LUTs. But at the same time, for example, if you're making 20 different TikToks or reels, for example, and you're mass making them in one sitting and then scheduling them for later, in that case, using LUTs and the desktop version of CapCut makes a lot of sense and can save you a lot of time and effort. And furthermore, using LUTs can teach you different type of edits you maybe wouldn't have been able to come up with otherwise. Now, where do you get these LUTs? I'm glad you asked. If you want my LUTs, the kind of edits that I use for my TikTok and my reels, they are up for sale on my website. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial. If you liked it, stay tuned, because the next video on this channel is probably going to be a Premiere Pro tutorial in the similar fashion.